Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel Naughty Threats. In case you are watching this video for the first time, do subscribe and also hit the bell icon so that you don't miss any of our future videos. Today's video is slightly different and interesting. So in case you guys have a sewing machine from Usha or brother which gives you an option to try different stitches, you can watch this video till the end, and in the end you will know just by using a normal sewing machine how we can create beautiful borders. For this I'm using two layers of paper canvas. See, paper canvas is generally very soft, it does not have any wax coating, and it is not buckram. Please note, it is not buckram. And the fabric that I'm using today is a piece of cotton silk that was lying around. So this is something I am trying for the first time. So even I am pretty much excited with the outcome. So then let's begin. So here I'm going to use zari. This is machine embroidery zari. It is completely different from the zari that we use in our ari or magam work. This one is used for handwork and it is generally thicker. Because of its thickness, it doesn't work with the machine. So in case you are using zari, you will have to ask for machine embroidery zari. And there are different colors available, just like you saw on the screen earlier. So I'm going to use this gold color for the first line. I'm threading it in the exact same way like how I thread my machine. So this is my brother DS140. It's a very old model. I bought this machine around 10 years ago, I think, precisely. So I think in 2009 or 2010 is when I bought this model. This is not even in production anymore. So you can go ahead and pick up something that is newer than this model. So in Brother, there are a lot of models available, even in Usha. Singer, anything is fine. This is not a promotional video. I'm not getting paid to talk about Brother company. I have Brother machine I am very happy with the brand, because the machine embroidery that I picked is also of the same company. That is the reason I'm just talking about Brother, because I own three different Brother sewing machines. So here I'm going to start off by setting the stitch to 4. So this is possible only if your machine has these kind of options. If your machine is just a normal sewing machine and does not have any stitch, inbuilt stitch options, then I'm afraid it is not possible. But most of the machines of late have these kind of options. So I have set the stitch to number 4, and this part here is to increase the stitch length or decrease. So I'm going to decrease it to 0.1, because by default number 4 is a zigzag stitch. So since I want it to be like a satin filling, I am decreasing the length of the stitch. And then this is the width, I will leave it at 4.5. so in this particular model there is option to increase and decrease the stitch length and width for every stitch. That's one interesting thing in this one. I'm really not sure how Usha or other machines are, because I have never used anything apart from Brother. So here I'm going to start off by pressing the foot down, and you can see how the satin stitch will turn out in few seconds. I had never used zari or any other thread in this machine. I have done a few simple necklines for my kurtis way too back when I actually purchased this machine. You know, when we buy something new, we have that excitement to try everything possible with that. So in that excitement, I did try a few. I don't even have those kurtis anymore, because it's more than 10 years old. So I have nothing to show you guys what I tried then. But then suddenly I got this thought of why not try to combine stitches to form a border. So I just tried using zari and it worked very well. So here my first line of satin stitch is done, and you guys can see how nice it is looking. So if you want just simple borders to be done on the sleeve, you can do it yourself. So next I'm going to try this 13, which is more like an arch. So again, I'm going to plus 10 and then minus 1. So by default, this is the stitch length and width. So length is 0.5 and width is 5.0. I'm going to reduce the width to 4.5. And let's increase the length a little so that the arch looks a little big. Same way, if you want, you can reduce the length as well. So totally up to you. I'm just trying some random stuff here. This was not even planned. So whatever is coming to my mind, I'm just doing it. So again, I'm putting the foot down, and to work this part, I have added silk thread. So this particular quality of silk thread is slightly different because when I used our normal silk thread that we use in Aari embroidery and Sari Kuchu, the thread started breaking every now and then. I tried reducing the tension, but that somehow didn't work in my favor, and that is the reason I'm using a different kind of silk thread. These came along with my computerized embroidery machine. These are not really silk thread, they are actually polyester threads. They're available in different colors. It has that shine like the silk thread, but it is just that it is much more stronger. It doesn't break easily when compared to the thread. So let's quickly see how this is going to look from the other side. So I was super excited when I got to this point, and because I have had this machine all my life and I never tried something like this. So I equally felt like laughing at myself for not trying this earlier, but yeah, better late than never, I believe. So next thing I'm going to try is 18. This is more like a chevron stitch. Recently, I think I also posted a chevron stitch video using normal needle. So using these kind of stitches, I mean, it's so exciting to just group them together and make it look like a border. So you guys definitely give it a try, and I would love to see your pictures. So my WhatsApp number is in the description box. So if you happen to try something like this, please do send me a pic and mention your machine and the model number. And I think I will probably share it in my YouTube community so that everybody who is using that model will be aware that something beautiful can be created with whatever they have. So this is the stitch number 18, which is more like a chevron stitch that I'm doing, and you guys can see how pretty it is coming out. It looks really delicate, not too heavy. And I purposely left some distance in between the zari, the gold satin that I did, and the chevron stitch, so that I can again fill it up with one line of satin using thread. So this will be the main highlight. And again, there is some space left in between the two. Here I actually thought of adding some stone chain or a line of sugar beads, just to give it a that handwork kind of touch. And you can see the fabric has not wrinkled that much. If you're going to use two layers of canvas, I'm sure your fabric will not get damaged. So it depends on the material that you're working as well. So this works absolutely well on this machine. And when I posted a Kannada video on this topic, a few of you came up saying I generally remove the foot and try to work a zigzag stitch on the stone chain. I think if your machine lets you do that, you can do it, but this machine doesn't run when I remove the foot. It starts beeping because the machine doesn't sense the foot. So it's not possible because this is a semi-computerized machine. It will never work without the foot. So if yours does, then you can go ahead and do that. But I'm going to hand stitch the stone chain later once it is dry. And just to add a little more look, I'm adding these small gold kundans because assuming that we will be doing these kind of designs on the blouse, on the silk blouse mainly. So this is how I have designed it. So do let me know in the comment section how you like this new idea or new try of mine. I am totally in love with it. I will try to see if I could create something more on similar lines. So yeah, I think in the next video I will post a few more designs of how you can mix and match the stitches to create some beautiful borders like this. And I have left some links in the description box, so do check it out. If in case you are planning to buy a sewing machine, I have linked few good models from Usha and Brother. So depending on your budget, you can go ahead and place orders. And also guys, now there is a good festival discounts available on Amazon. So please do check it out and make the most of it. Yeah, I guess that's all. I hope you guys like this video. In case you like it, don't forget to hit that thumbs up. And if you're watching the video without subscribing, head over now and subscribe guys, and also hit the bell icon. Also subscribe to my other channel, Kanika Reddy Vlogs, and please don't forget to check out my blog naughtythreads.net because I'm spending a lot of time in updating very useful and very informative content there. So I guess that's all. I shall see you guys soon. Until then, take care.